fishing.
What?
Well, first you gotta choose the right bait, and you have to know when to reel it in.
Tom, about the other day, I didn't mean to suggest...
Yes, you did. I apologize, and thank you.
I accept.
I am in Digicom's future. Which brings us to our advanced products group. Tom Sanders heads our manufacturing department. Tom, I wonder if you can come up here and review for us the revolutionary new product we call Arcamax.
Thank you, Meredith. Arcamax is our own standalone CD-ROM drive player. Now, for a CD-ROM drive to be effective, it has to be portable and it has to be fast. Arcamax is twice as fast as any CD-ROM drive in the world today. We're in production, we've had our problems, but we are solving them.
And the problems we've had, are they design problems?
No, Meredith, there are fabrication problems involving the production line in Malaysia.
What sort of problems?
Well, for example, we should be using automatic chip installers to lock the controller chip on the boards. The Malayans been doing it by hand, literally jamming the chips in with their thumbs. And the quality of the air in the plant is dirty. We should be using level 7 air handlers. We're using only level 5. And we're ordering our components like hinge rods and clips not from our Singapore supplier, but from someone's a lot cheaper, but also less reliable.
I'm confused here. You set up this line, Tom. You didn't anticipate these problems?
Well, the line was changed. The specifications were altered.
How is that possible? I mean, we all know you to be a highly competent manager.
Well, you should know, Meredith. You ordered the changes.
I don't know where you could have gotten that idea.
Weren't you in Kuala Lumpur last year?
To settle a labor dispute, but that had nothing to do with the line. I've never even seen the line.
You've never seen the line?
No, I don't know who could have told you such a...
You're watching Malaysian Channel 3 right now.
Perhaps instead of digging up Malaysian video clips, we should discuss the problem sitting right in front of us. Problems in your department with the line that you set up.
All right. The first memo in the file is being handed out to you is signed by Meredith Johnson, and it states that manual labor will be used to install the chips. Now, that made the Malaysian government very happy. It also meant voltage irregularities and memory allocation
problems.
That was
a complex negotiation. The Malay government insisted
that Malaysian government does not own shares of Digicom. All of these people here do. The second memo reduces the air handling capacity in order to cut the costs. And that's why we're getting dirt in the split optics, in the drive arms, the chip joints. The resulting delays will actually increase the costs by more than 70%. The third memo regarding the Singapore supplies
is not... Your responsibility, not mine. These problems were created because of your incompetence, not mine. This is exactly the problem with this division. Passing the buck and political backstabbing.
Meredith,
I'm not through, Bob. This so-called evidence of yours, Mr. Sanders, is fooling no one. Now, you can come down here and showboat and protect your little turf and think it means something. But the fact is, you were not informed of these decisions because they were over your head. Now, when we talk about this merger, we are talking about a synergy between hardware and software, between cash flow and capital needs. But I guess that's just a language you can't understand.
Well, I don't understand it either. I thought we were buying this company because they could build things. You understand what the heck she's talking about?
I just was trying to accurately convey the sentiments of everyone here. That's what I intended to do.
Meredith, could you step outside for a moment, please?